Terima kasih atas waktu yang sudah Ibu Guru dan para audiens luangkan untuk hadir menyaksikan presentasi saya hari ini. Dalam kesempatan ini, saya, Helen Faith, akan menyampaikan hasil penelitian karya ilmiah saya yang berjudul Pengaruh Film Kriminal Terhadap Perilaku Remaja di Indonesia.
Saat ini, krisis pangan di Indonesia terus meningkat. Menurut statistik, prevalensi ketidakcukupan konsumsi pangan di tahun 2021 ke 2022 meningkat hampir 2%. Oleh karena itu, teknologi yang kini telah banyak dikembangkan dapat dimanfaatkan untuk mendorong ketahanan pangan Indonesia. Salah satu contoh teknologi di masa kini yang dapat menjadi salah satu jawaban krisis pangan di Indonesia adalah GMO.
Dalam bukunya yang berjudul Peran Literasi Digital di Masa Pandemik, Devri Suherdi mengatakan bahwa literasi digital tidak hanya tentang pengetahuan, tetapi juga kecakapan dalam menggunakan teknologi digital. Saya akan menggunakan definisi ini sepanjang karya ilmiah saya. Untuk mengenalkan dan memberikan pemahaman mengenai literasi digital secara singkat, Kominfo membagi literasi digital menjadi 4 pilar yang berbeda. Saya akan menggunakan akronim CABE untuk mempermudah mengingatnya.
Seringkali remaja salah memahami mengenai arti citra kedewasaan karena mereka mendapatkan dukungan dari komunitas yang salah. Pada umumnya, contoh kenakalan remaja adalah dengan merokok, mabuk, narkoba, dan terlibat dalam perilaku seks bebas. Kenakalan remaja tersebut dianggap sebagai citra kedewasaan di kebanyakan kalangan remaja. Pemahaman ini salah dan perlu diperbaiki, karena dapat mempengaruhi pengambilan keputusan di kehidupan para remaja.
Apakah Anda berpikir bahwa obat tablet cetirizin yang memiliki harga lebih murah akan memiliki kualitas yang lebih buruk dari tablet rival? Jika Anda berpikir demikian, maka Anda tidak sendirian. Ada banyak juga orang-orang di luar sana yang juga berpikir demikian dan berspekulasi bahwa harga lebih murah berarti kualitas yang lebih rendah.
Berdasarkan penelitian dilakukan tentang efektivitas penggunaan artificial intelligence dalam kegiatan pembelajaran, dapat disimpulkan bahwa AI bersifat efektif untuk digunakan dalam kegiatan pembelajaran walaupun ada beberapa efek negatif. Efek positif dari AI untuk para murid adalah meningkatnya pemahaman materi dan menariknya proses pembelajaran. Untuk para guru, efek positif AI adalah meningkatkannya efisiensi kinerja pada para guru saat membuat materi pengajaran.
Dapat disimpulkan bahwa remaja-remaja CBCS tidak asing terhadap efek negatif media sosial, namun banyak responden merasa bahwa walaupun media sosial mempengaruhi kesehatan mental mereka, namun faktor-faktor eksternal lain seperti keluarga, lingkungan sosial, dan tuntunan sekolah memiliki dampak yang lebih signifikan terhadap kesehatan mental. Sekian dari presentasi yang telah saya berikan, semoga bermanfaat bagi kita semua dan kita dapat mempelajari sesuatu. Terima kasih telah mendengarkan presentasi karya ilmiah saya dan Tuhan memberkati.
Maria, a 14-year-old garment worker, works in a busy industrial neighborhood at a fast fashion factory in hopes of making a good life. She and her coworkers frequently go to extra hours to fulfill production targets, but their pay hardly makes up for it. She and her coworkers are stuck in a never-ending cycle of exploitation from the fast fashion factories. In order to combat this issue, a variety of strategies has been done. Social media campaigns, slow fashion, and upcycling has grown in popularity. Exposure to wet textile processes, synthetic fibers, and dyes is a common cause of health impacts. The fast fashion industry also uses children to cut costs, which ends up in child labor. The government could also monitor the working conditions of these workers even more. Together, individuals and government could work together to solve the ongoing issue of exploitation, waste, and consumption. By trying to help each other and trying to realize our mistakes and follow all the standards given out by the authority. Thank you.
Imagine a world where students can pursue their passions without the fear of judgment. A world where schools aid students into turning their hobbies into a career. A world where schools encourage students to do what they love. Schools all over the globe embrace the world of esports, creating teams for student gamers to excel.
What you're promoting is actually the opposite of a classical Christian education because you're not practicing embodied learning. You're removing yourself from reality.
Esports is like very digital, and like I said, it's like an activity done in isolation, right? Which is why I actually believe we should have these programs, because if we do it in school, these gamers can meet with one another, their teammates, that's physical interaction that they might not have at home. And these esports, like discussing tactics, strategies, and like really just talking and learning how to communicate.
Have you ever wished for a genie in a bottle? We also have a genie on our own, that in writing. It can give you answers for anything you need with just a few clicks on your keyboard. Yes, this is everyone's best friend, ChatGPT. However, one out of these three students have been using this chatbot as a source for their academic writing. This is qualitatively different than that of an academic research source, because by definition, ChatGPT is a chatbot. Its main job is to chat and give data accordingly in a conversational way. While academic resources, which etymologically means to rise, should either elevate or deepen the writing effectively. This is what the future of education may look like, where 90% of the cognition process is delegated to AI, and nobody learns anything. Will you let your own creation, this creation of ours, rule over ourselves and waste 4 more years of your life learning nothing? Or start to be mindful stewards of this creation of ours as God intended us to be? This decision is yours to take. Thank you.
Well, ideally, students should long for knowledge and understanding, but over the years, this culture of curious thinkers who loves to learn grows dim because of homework. Exhausted parents arrive home from work and expect to rest, to have quality time with their children, and yet they arrive home just to receive more work in the form of supervising their children's homework. Surely, the role of parents gradually shifts from loving parents into ruthless teachers.
How is university structured and the load that you need to manage? So I'm just saying, how would you speak to that?
Homework kind of spoon-feeds students into what they should learn. If students are trained to think for themselves of what they should learn for a test and get used to an independent study, they would instead get more prepared for college.
But they might say, I would rather do this at home anyway. So how do you comment on that?
Actually, what is good from doing it at school is that teachers can actually accompany their children in doing homework and give constant feedback, and students too are not afraid to make mistakes or ask questions. Yeah. While instead, if they are at home, they might actually not do it at all, because lazy students will be lazy students no matter what.
Good job, Joelle. You completed it. Did a great job.
Did you know that charging your phone can be equivalent to burning the world? This is our harsh reality, that most of our energy sources still originate from fossil fuels, which has led to global warming. Can the marvels of today's technology properly address a culture of progress, including a culture of preservation for our very planet? China offers a pathway for developing countries to transition to renewable energy. We have seen that China, with its historical, economic, and sympathetic success, underscores its success in tailoring projects to suit developing countries' needs. Let us come together and ensure a renewable energy transition where no one is left behind. Thank you. My name is Scarlett.